Hello, so this is the dark ending or the dark side ending. So you should normally save your game before you build the watchtower, and I already built the watchtower in the previous episode. And that's the only way you can ensure you see all three endings of the DLC. So the best ending or the good ending is when you decide not to help Beatrice and then speak with Kukul and tell him that he was insulted by Beatrice. I think you also need 3 gold coins for that as well. Now the bad ending or the very very sad ending when you lose the camp is if you decide to help Beatrice and then speak with Kukul to betray her. So that means you'll have to tell everyone in the camp, okay, it's over, go home. And they just leave the camp empty. Now we'll be doing the dark side ending, which is helping Beatrice and actually helping Beatrice. So for that you need 5 emulsions of death. So how are they made? Well, you have to have dark brains, or there is another way. The dark brains are very hard to get because you basically need to be at end game. Because your character needs to have the perks to do it. He needs to have the whatever that was called. Cultist, and you also need to do the Inquisitor quest, which allows you to get the dark brain or the dark parts. So that's a very, very hard way to do it. There is also an alternative way, which is not really mentioned. And remember the dungeon, you can go into the dungeon and destroy the slimes. And also you have a few black slimes over there. So yeah, you have to go at either the zombie or the hand mixer. And you can also use the Tarak slime. So it's a lot easier like this, or the black jelly. So the black jelly that you get from killing the black slimes, you can also make the death solutions, which will make the death emulsion for you also. We didn't research the cloak. Black and gold cloak. So let's do that now. Normally you do this with a cake. Oh. Fine, we'll try to bake a cake and other things. So, after you get the death solution, you can make the death emulsion over here. As you can see, it doesn't take long and you should have them very, very fast. From what I can see, it's 10. You get 10 of them for 2 death solutions. So that means you basically have to kill 1 or 2 black slimes, or you can just get a dark brain. I think they modified this at some point because it was kind of hard to make them before. Okay, let's bake a cake for the ending because this is a good DLC, but it has kind of like a mixed feeling to it, because the problem is that it also will end on the... I need honey. It will also end on the giant cliffhanger. So once again, the developers are preparing a new DLC. And the next DLC, or the third one and the last one, or the fourth one if you are playing on consoles, because remember, the zombie DLC was free for PC users only. Consoles had to pay for it, from what I remember. So let's just bake a nice cake to kind of symbolize the ending of the DLC. And after this you'll get 2 perks. One of them will kind of regenerate your energy and it will not allow you to sleep anymore. So that's a little weird, but I guess we can do it. Let's sleep a little bit. All of these endings are actually pretty good, but this is the final version of the DLC probably, which was patched about 10 times in the end. People had a different experience with the game, especially... Okay, let's also get the faith points, especially because the game was not really explaining to you what you are doing, so... Indeed, a lot of people chose the wrong option and then they basically destroyed the entire DLC by clearing the camp, which left you with nothing. Bake the cake, eat the cake. Put the clock over here and let's see how much points we get for it. That was a lot of points actually. Yeah, so that was the confetti actually. Think of that as the confetti for the DLC. Okay, now let's go and finish the mission. The problem is that Kukul generally hangs around during the night time only. So you have to skip time again, and yeah, it's a little annoying that you have to skip so much time. Study complete. I was actually expecting to get some kind of achievement for that, but nope. So let's refresh our memories. Kukul is actually This guy of no no, that's the Shepherd. I always get them confused. Tell him about Lady Beatrice's plan, so he'll only show up during the night time and he sells you weapons and armor from the fort. So he's a little harder to find, especially because he's in the forest area of the map. Now, if you ask me, the DLC is definitely worth it and it adds a lot of stuff to the game, and of course the bags, the recipes, the improved quality of other stuff. But it's not really required. I think the other DLC had a lot more punch to it. It had a lot more, I don't know, story to it. And this DLC definitely kind of closes up the story, but again, it doesn't really tell you the whole deal, and yeah, you'll still have to fight to understand what's happening. And sadly, you kind of have to replay the whole game again to kind of get the full story, because without the two DLCs, the game feels a little weird. And what do I mean by that? Well, you... Oh, we had another memory over here. Give it to me. An old falcon... Oh... Ashes cutlet to the... Oh, that's so nice. He's a really nice person, Kukul. Okay, this one as well. Yeah, he betrayed Kukul. That snake is a snake. So yeah, let's go into the final portion of the game. So this is what happens if you talk to him. So you kind of have to make up your mind before you do that. Code Org. Retribution. You're smarter than expected or cowardly. Loyalty and obedience for us. So this was not a one-time deal. It's just one step. Will the refugees be safe? Of course. So no one must know of our little spy play. It's the middle of the night again. Now I wanted to talk to Kukul to kind of show you what happens if you kind of choose the wrong ending, and it's hard to do anyway. Besides, there are a lot of things I still don't understand about the free ending, so let's just leave it at that. I mentioned them and you kind of know what they are. Oh, now I have to wait again. Okay, let's meditate. Like I said, it will be funny to play the game without the DLCs right now, because it feels like the DLCs actually added a lot more to the game than I expected, especially in the way of quest, in the way of rewards, and in the way, of course, of alternative ways to finish the quest. For example, having the bags, having the tavern really makes it a lot more easier to gather all the gold you needed for the quests. Okay, let's go to the refugee camp. Yeah, so all of this is kind of like the final step, so remember, you should save your game before you build this tower over here. Eh, such a busy camp. Look at all those happy faces. 16 happy faces maximum. You are Teodoro, right? Yes. Then when? Come on. I like playing tag with him, okay. So he doesn't let me ask him about the Quagmire. I don't know why, but that's... the DLC. No one will disturb you. They're all alive thanks to you. People, everyone, come here. Okay, let's have the celebration party. Let's have the onion rings, the beer, and the hamburgers. Okay, no hamburgers. Maybe we should just have... Maybe you should just have mushroom, roasted mushrooms. Yes, we are. Our new home is shelter for anyone who wants to the Brotherhood of the Graveyard Clan. Alright, thank you. It's almost like a sermon. The town, the native land, with fire and sword. Alright, remember this day and he's okay, we remember. Now I have to speak to Alaric, because we chose the dark side, he might leave the camp. Get away as far as possible from Theodore and his people. I think he leaves the camp no matter what you do, because he's still a vampire that sucks the blood of people. I'll try to find the desert, which is said to be the wisest of women. Okay, so this is what they meant. The desert, which is something we don't have access, and she knows a way to stop the ancient curse, because right now we're stuck with the ancient curse again. And you made this disgusting world a little better. 100 relation with him. And why does Theodora hate Alaric so much? So this is the first perk you get. Dark Persistence. So that means you recover energy all the time, which is kind of great, but it's kind of useless. I think this is very hard to get in the normal game anyway. We already had those. Ah, you can just keep him here for safekeeping. And that's kind of it. It doesn't really tell you a lot of information. It just ends. Now, I know we still have one more thing to do, and that's go home. Probably sleep, or I'm not sure, because you have to find the body in the morgue. Because remember, with the 5 death emulsion, she actually kills 5 soldiers, and she creates... What is 25 out of 22? She creates ghouls, because the ghouls were always teased. Okay. So let's take that away. And now I should keep the bodies, because they are a little bit unique. Doesn't really say much about them. So, note from unknown. A tiny request, my dear. These soldiers refuse their injections. Keeping them alive was a risk. 1,000 kisses and stay in touch, our work together has just begun. And you can craft a little better. So this is, I think, the perk you get for helping Beatrice. Now, what do these perks do? Well, craft more effectively. That's not... You will craft a little more items. But again, the items you can craft are not so important in this part of the game. So that's it. That's how it ends. With a lot of dead bodies here on the road and inside. Now, I really hope the next DLC comes along very, very soon. In the meantime, I'll just prepare by organizing my camp a little better, by having a little more money and so on, because we'll definitely have another DLC. That's all for now. Bye.